Hello students, I hope you all are fine. In this video, we will continue exercise 5.2 from question number 14, that is how many multiples of 4 lie between 10 and 250. Means we are to find out the number of numbers those are multiples of 4 lying between 10 and 250. We have multiples of 4 lying between 10 and 250 as 12, 16, 20 and dashes up to 48. Now we have to find out the number of numbers. So here we have A1 as 12, A2 as 16. So D would be A2 minus A1 and becomes 16 minus 12, that is 4. Or we can directly use D as 4 as we are using the multiple of 4. So and AN as 248. Now by using the formula that is AN equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. We have AN as 248, A as 12 plus N minus 1 into D as 4. Now 248 is 12 will be transposed to the left hand side and become negative, and right hand side would be the same, n minus 1 into 4. Now 8 minus 2 becomes 6, 4 minus 1 become 3, and this become 236 equals to n minus 1 into 4. Now this 4 will be transposed to the right left hand side and becomes 236 upon 4 equals to n minus 1. Now 4 5 is 20 and 4 9 is 36. So 59 would be equals to n minus 1, or we can write it as n minus 1 equals to 59, or n equals to 59 plus 1, or n equals to 60. Thus, the number of numbers those are multiple of 4 lying between 10 and 250 is 60. Now the question number 15, for what value of n are the nth terms of the two APs, that is 63, 65, 67 and second AP is 3, 10, 17 and so on, are equal. Means we are to find out the value of n for which the nth term of two APs are equal. So we can say the first AP we have A1 as 63, A2 as 65. So D would be A2 minus A1, that is 65 minus 63. It becomes 2, that is D equals to 2 for the first AP. So AN would be A plus N minus 1 into D for the first AP. So that A is 63 plus N minus 1 into D is 2. Open the bracket, 63 plus 2 into 1. Sorry, 2 into N becomes 2N and 2 into 1 becomes 2. So that 63 minus 2 becomes 61 plus 2N. For the first AP, we have AN as 61 plus 2N. Now, for the second AP, in the second AP, we have first term as A1 dash, we can say that is 3, A2 dash equals to 10, so that D dash would be A2 dash minus A1 dash, that is 10 minus 3, so that D dash would be 7. Now we have D dash. Now we have to find the general term or nth term of second AP, that is AN dash, would be A dash plus N minus 1 into D dash. So that A1, that is A1 dash, that is 3 plus N minus 1 into D dash is 7. Now open the bracket, 3 plus 7 into N becomes 7N minus 7. 3 minus 7, we can write it as 7N minus 7. So 7N remains same. 3 minus 7 become minus 4. AN dash is 7N minus 4. Now, According to question, we have given that an and an dash are equal, so that 61 plus 2n would be equals to 7n minus 4, and 61, this 4 will be transposed to the left hand side and become plus 4, and 7n, this 2n would be transposed to the right hand side and become 2n minus 2n. 7n minus 2n becomes 5n, and in the left hand side 61 plus 4 becomes 65, or we can write it as 5n equals to 65 implies n equals to 65 upon 5. This becomes 13 5 65, so that n equals to 13. N equals to 13. In the next problem, we have determine the AP whose third term is 16 and seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. Means we are given that seventh term is 12 more than its fifth term, and third term is 16. So now we have to find the AP. Thus, in this problem, we have given the difference of seventh term and fifth term as 12, number relation 1, and third term is, that is A3 equals to 16. We can say A3, that is A plus 2D equals to 16. That is number 2. Now A7 becomes A plus 6D minus A5 can be written as A plus 4D equals to 12. Now A plus 6D minus A minus 4D equals to 12. Minus A and plus A will be cancelled. 6D minus 4D becomes 2D equals to 12, and 2D equals to 12. So that D would be 12 by 2, that is 6. D is 6. Now, from equation number 2, we can say equation number 2 is A plus 2D equals to 16. So that A plus 2 into D, that is 6, equals to 16. So A plus 2 into 6 becomes 12 equals to 16, and A equals to 16 minus 12, so that we have A equals to 4. Now we have A as a 4 and D as a 6. So now we can determine the AP. Now the required AP would be as followed: A1, A2, A3, dash dash, so on. Now A1 can be written as A2 can be written as A plus D, A3 can be written as A plus 2D, and so on. Now A, we have A as a 4, A plus D means 4 plus 6, and A plus 2D becomes A plus 2D becomes 4 plus 2 into 6, and so on. Now 4 plus 6 becomes 10, 4 plus 2 into 6, 2 into 6 becomes 12, 12 plus 4 becomes 16, so that we have 4, 10, 16, and dash dash, so on. This is the required AP. Pause the video and note it down. In the next problem, that is question number 17, we have to find the 20th term from the last term of AP. That AP is 3, 8, 13, and dash dash 253. Now we have to find out the 20th term from this n term, that is 253. We have to find the 20th term from this last term. We have given AP. We have given AP as 3, 8, 13, and dash dash 253. Now here A1 is 3, A2 is 8, so D would be A2 minus A1. Now D would be 8 minus 3 becomes 5. D is 5. Now here AN is 253. By using formula, AN is equals to A plus N minus 1 into D, we have A plus N minus 1 into D equals to 253. Here A is 3 and D is 5, so that we can put a and d in this relation. Now 3 plus 5 into n becomes 5n minus 5 equals to 253. Now 5n, 3 minus 5 becomes minus 2 equals to 253, and 5n equals to 253 plus 2, and 5n equals to 255, and n would be equals to 255 upon 5. 5 5 is 25 and 5 1 is 5, so that we have n equals to 51. Thus we can say in this given AP we have 51 terms. Now an important relation we have, 20th term from the last would be equals to n plus 1 minus 20th term from beginning. We can directly find out the 20th term from end by using the formula n plus 1 minus 20th term from beginning. So, and we have 51, so that 51 plus 1 minus 20th term from beginning. 52 minus 20, so that it becomes 32, 32nd term from beginning would be equals to 20th term from last, so that we need to find the 32nd term from beginning. Now A32 would be A plus 31 into D. We have A as 3 plus 31 and D as 5, so that 3 plus 31 into 1, sorry, 31 into 5 becomes 155, and this becomes 158. So the 20th term from end is 158. Thus 20th term from end is 158. There is another method to solve this problem. Now we have given AP as 3, 8, 13 and dash dash up to 253. We can rewrite this AP as 253, 248, dash dash, 13, 8 and 3. Now we are to find 20th term from the end of this term, or we can directly find out 20th term from beginning of this AP. So here we have A1 as 253, A2 as 248. So D would be A2 minus A1, that is 248 minus 253. This become minus 5. Now D is minus 5. Now we have to find 20th term. So A20 would be equals to A plus 19D. And A is 253 plus 19 into minus 5. This becomes 253 minus 95. And this would be 158. Thus, the 20th term from end of the given AP is 158. The answer. Now, the next problem is question number 18. That is, the sum of the 4th and 8th term of an AP is 24. And the sum of 6th and 10th term is 44. Find the first 3 terms of the given AP. We have given sum of 4th and 8th term, that is A4 plus A8 equals to 24, and sum of 6th term and 10th term, that is A6 plus A10 as 44. Now solve these relations. A4 can be written as A plus 3D, and A8 can be written as A plus 7D equals to 24. Now A plus A becomes 2A, so that 2A plus 3D and plus 7D becomes 10D. 2A plus 10D equals to 24, relation number 1. A6 can be written as A plus 5D. A10 can be written as A plus 9D equals to 44. A plus A becomes 2A. 5D plus 9D becomes 14D equals to 44, relation number 2. Now, from equation 1 and 2, we have 2a plus 14d equals to 44. And from relation 1, we have 2a plus 10d equals to 24. On subtraction, sign would be changed. 2a will be cancelled. 14d minus 10d becomes 4d, and 44 minus 24 becomes 20. So d will be 20 upon 4 becomes 5. So d is 5. Now from equation 1, a 2a plus 10 into d, that is 5, equals to 24. So 2a plus 50 equals to 24. 2a equals to 24 minus 50, and 2a equals to minus 26, and a would be minus 26 upon 2, it becomes minus 13. So a is minus 13. Now we have a as minus 13 and d as 5. Thus the first three terms of AP are A1, A2 and A3. Here A1 is A, A2 is A plus D, and A3 is A plus 2D. It becomes A is minus 13, and A plus D, that is minus 3 plus 5, becomes minus 8, and next one would be minus 3. Thus, three required terms of AP are minus 13, minus 8 and minus 3. And the next question is question number 19, in which we are given Subba Rao started work in 1995 at an annual salary of rupees 5000 and received an increment of rupees 200 each year. In which year did his income reach rupees 7000? Means in the beginning his salary was rupees 5000 and annual increment is rupees 200, that is constant difference. So this is D and A is 5000, and his salary becomes rupees 7000, that is A and V are given. So we have given A as rupees 5000, D as 200, D as rupees 200, and A and as rupees 7000. So now by using formula, An equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. An we have 7000, A is 5000, plus N minus 1 into D is 200. Now transpose 5000 to the left hand side, 7000 minus 5000 equals to N minus 1 into 200. This becomes 2000 equals to N minus 1 into 200. Now this 200 will be transposed to the left hand side and becomes reciprocal, so that it becomes 2000 upon 200 equals to N minus 1. 200 tends 2000, so that we can write it as N minus 1 equals to 10, or N equals to 10 plus 1, that is 11. So N equals to 11. Now we can say in the 11th year his salary will reach rupees 7000. Thus in 11th year his income reach rupees 7000. In the next problem, we have given Ram Kali saved rupees 5 in the first week of a year and then increased her saving by rupees 1.75. if in the nth week her weekly saving become rupees 20.75, find the N. We have to find. Thus, from above information, we can say we have given A as rupees 5, D as rupees 1.75, and AN as rupees 20.75. So now we need to find N by using the formula, that is an equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. And here we have a as 20.75 and a is 5 plus n minus 1 remains same and d is 1.75. 20.75 minus this 5 will be transferred to the left hand side, so that 20.75 minus 5 equals to n minus 1 into 1.75. Now this becomes 15.75 equals to n minus 1 into 1.75, and this 1.75 will be transposed to the left hand side and become 15.75 upon 1.75 and equals to n minus 1. Now as the numerator and denominator both are in like fraction, so we can write it as 15.75 upon 1.75 equals to n minus 1. And these two terms will be cancelled each other at 9. So we can write it as n minus 1 equals to 9, or n equals to 9 plus 1, so n equals to 10. Thus we can say, thus in 10th week her weekly saving become rupees 20.75. So pause the video and note it down. This is all about exercise 5.2. In next video, that is very important, in that video we will discuss the basic of exercise 5.3. So keep watching.